Yo, what up, y'all? It's the motherfucking Normies coming live from the House of the Black and White. No, we're not actually live. We're live right at the moment, though.
We're live right now.
I said yo to the TV, not the camera.
So, this is season two, episode seven of Rick and Morty. I forget what the name of it is.
Big Trouble in Little Sanchez.
There it is.
Siri beat you.
Siri doesn't understand.
Siri's a cocksucker. So, fuck her. Alright, it's called Big Trouble in Little Sanchez. What do you guys think's gonna happen?
Ooh.
Wait, what is it? Big Trouble
I'm sure there's gonna be some homages to Big Trouble in Little China.
Ooh. So, Sanchez is Rick's last name, so maybe.
They're not Mexican at all.
We're going to see a little Sanchez.
Well,
you mean childhood of Rick?
Yeah.
Oh,
nice. A dirty Sanchez. My roommate just said dirty Sanchez. She's right here. My hands are here. No, both hands. One foot.
All right. Out of limb each time.
There it is. She's her picture is right here. That's what she looks like.
One of the lunch ladies died. They found her in the gym with like two holes in her neck and all the blood streaming out of her.
Where's
the pepper?
Wait, what? Vampires are real?
Yes, Summer, vampires are real. Who knew? Oh, right, all humanity for hundreds of years now.
Yeah. Grandpa Rick, couldn't you, like, use your super knowledge to turn yourself into a teenager and come to our school and help us hunt the vampire down?
Little Sancho.
Wow. Yeah, pretty specific pitch, Summer. I probably could turn myself into a teenager and hang out in the zit-covered, hormone-addled, low-stakes ass world that is high school, but here's my reverse ask. Why in the f*** would I ever do that? And how dare you even ask me that? And why aren't you more ashamed of yourself?
Jesus.
Dear, to our daughters.
Christ! God. You fix your marriage or get a divorce already?
I don't think they fixed them.
We tried a couple.
That was in another universe.
That's Earth therapy. You might as well ask a horse to fix a merry-go-round. I mean, he'll try his best, but mostly he's just gonna get horrified. I know about a place off-planet with 100% success rate.
Don't
even. Do you think Mom and Dad are, you know, gonna get a divorce?
I think it's okay to dream, Morty. I'm gonna go make some wooden steaks.
But didn't they make up when the big head came and showed them?
No, they were being nice to each other because, I mean, that was it. They didn't.
They've made up plenty of times. It's always.
They've never made up for realsies. They've done nice things for each other, but their marriage has always been rocky. I mean, do you not remember the end of the Mr. Poopy Butthole episode? After she shot Mr. Poopy Butthole, and he calls and he goes, "My wife just shot one of our law." I said, "Come on, if it's your wife, you ain't supposed to call and snitch on her like that." I got you, boo.
You need to meet Mr. Poopy Butthole, Mickey.
Mr.
Poopy Butthole is my favorite.
Oh, Zoom's not rolling.
He's most successful couples counseling institute. They can save the marriage of a dog and a bar of dark chocolate. Shit, have fun. See you Thursday.
Oh my god.
Jerk.
Don't insult my father. He's the reason our kids are only half stupid.
Ha! You just called yourself.
Yes. Jerry, go ahead and sit there.
That's awesome.
Put this on. This machine isolates the subject's brain contains all perceptions of its romantic partner. And we will now render Jerry's perception of Beth with artificial, biological life. Interesting.
What the fuck?
Take that back! You do not fit that puppy!
See what you both
mean. Oh, so now you're too cool for this just because Grandpa Rick is?
It's not that, it's just that the universe is a little too big to care about something so small.
There's several Gravity Falls references in this one.
Who wants to hunt a vampire?
What?
Rick, how did you... Yeah, I got bored and I remembered this morning how I blew Summer off. And
Little Sanchez.
Hey, why are you such a grumpy douche, Rick? Go to the garage, transfer your mind into a younger clone of yourself, and get embroiled in some youthful hijinks.
Oh my god, Toby Matthews.
Fuck you, Summer.
I'm Tiny Rick. I'm new. Hey, go easy on me. Just kidding.
Tiny Rick.
I like your straightforward style.
And that lab coat's pretty cool.
The voice of that guy is the creator of Gravity Falls.
Wow. You're nice. Great. But let's hunt a vampire with my grandkids.
Tiny Rick.
Tiny Rick.
Watch your mythologues interact together. Adapt. We can communicate. And most importantly,
she's got like an alien look.
Who would have suspected? elected Coach Feratu.
Coach Feratu.
We should be proud of ourselves. We killed a vampire and the gym teacher. Talk about two for one, right?
For real? You would stay as Tiny Rick just so we could have a party?
Hell yeah. What's one more night? And who can have fun with this old bastard hanging around, huh?
I like how he still has a unibrow.
Tiny Rick!
Moving on? Now. Wait, what? What's going on? Where are the Smith Mythologs?
It's gonna eat him.
Oh
my god.
They're real? God damn.
I thought it was. Oh my god.
You know what's fun? Our gift shop. Why don't we proceed in an orderly
God damn, Beth.
Let me out. What you see is not the same person as me. My life's a lie. I'm not who you're looking at. Let me out. Set me free. I'm really old, but me. Help me. I'm gonna die. Tiny Rick.
Tiny Rick.
Oh, fuck.
How would you actually create these?
What kind of operation are you running?
Us? What the hell kind of relationship do you have? Blame this on us.
Okay, I can and I am. You have the single worst marriage I've ever witnessed. It shouldn't exist. You should never, ever, ever have gotten together, and I do not understand how or why you would ever stay together.
Well, this is just bad couples.
You don't want to find your own little hatch?
Jerry, I believe that if you hide by yourself, you might survive. And I believe I, by myself, have a shot of getting out of here. But the two of us, together, I don't know. Maybe the shrink was right. All right, now you listen to me. Or don't.
Hey, don't, please.
So what makes me so rad?
Why does it say, help me, Morty and Summer?
Come on, Summer, that's the title of the art.
Sounds.
Wait, for real? You know how Beth sees me? I've had these thoughts about me. I don't know where my wife is. You are going to help me. Nobody's doing that.
What do you want?
Jerry's an army.
An army of Jerry's.
The value of his subservience is wasted on you. I will use it to dominate the universe.
Oh boy, Jerry must think I'm pretty stupid for you to be this stupid. Wouldn't it make more sense to put my dumbass husband in this chair so you can make an army of your badass self?
I'm the strongest, smartest being alive.
Yeah, that's what
Jerry thinks you're that much stronger and smarter than you are.
Morty, Jessica, what's up? Check out the new dance I made up.
Last time there was a dance, Rick destroyed the universe.
Let me out. This is not a dance. I'm begging for help. I'm stuck. Please come let me out.
Oh my god.
That's a wicked character.
That last part was really weird.
It's gonna break my heart wide open. Your great student, the fact that you're an 80-year-old man in a clone body, never bothered me. This here's another matter. You recognize this? We had a tip that was in your locker.
Oh, so I guess there's no need to stay young.
What are you talking about? Screw your top! You ran it on me!
I just saved your life!
High school is my life! Summer Smith is a psycho nerd and she just got me kicked out of school!
Oh my god.
Oh god, Jerry.
Look at them, they're all like...
to the real thing.
Nice.
That's it.
It's me, your husband. I'm here to save you. Oh, my name isn't Jerry Smith.
Stop talking.
Fair enough. Oh, no.
Oh. Good night. Tough, huh, Morty? What are you gonna do? I'm Tiny Rick. I'm the coolest kid in your school. How are you gonna just make me do whatever you say, huh?
I'm gonna do what real Rick would do if he was here. I'm gonna kick your ass!
That's it, we're gonna hold him down! Listen to it, Tiny Rick. Listen to Elliot Smith. Feel what he's feeling.
How can someone so talented die so young? What is being young? I'm not young, I'm old. I'm gonna die. My body isn't real. Morty, Summer, it's me. It's Rick.
Jerry, you can't bend metal.
I can make a can.
How can I do that while I'm watching you totally fail to bend metal?
Oh. Oh, God.
This representation displeases me.
Oh, God.
Well, I had a feeling that in your mind, the ideal version of me is one smart enough to see you as a goddess.
Not such a stupid worm now.
That's hilarious.
Holy shit! Thanks, kids. You figured it out. Well, Summer did. This. Operation Phoenix is not the fallback I thought it would be.
Oh my god.
Oh my god! The man of me! Oh my oh god!
I really like the Beth and Jerry side story of this one.
Yeah, it was really good. Like, the B story was as solid as the fucking A story was. What's your theory, Sriracha Chef?
So, I don't know why I thought of it randomly, but, like, when the alien was saying, like, I have no idea, like, why you two are together, like, you two are, like, the worst married couple ever, I'm like, maybe Rick put them together on purpose so Morty could be created somehow.
Rick doesn't time travel, though.
True,
he said multiple times that's not his thing. Also, if that was the case, that would mean that every Rick has have to have done that because every Rick has a Morty.
That's true. So maybe, I don't know.
But there might be something to that.
Yeah. They haven't shown how they first...
Well, but there was even a time at the daycare we saw the other guy when Beth remarries.
Oh,
remember?
Yeah.
And they were like, yeah, Beth remarries me. Don't worry, I don't overstep my boundaries with the kids. So,
yeah.
In alternate universes, they've always had kids, what it seems like, but... Or for the most part, except for the interdimensional commercial one.
Yeah.
But this time they had kids.
Well, I'll just spitball on. But yeah, I
you
like
it wrong.
I like Little Sanchez.
Tiny Rick!
Tiny Rick!
Tiny Rick!
That's hilarious. Tiny Rick. Oh my god, those were. It was funny when he went down the basement, they were like all the like baby Rick. It was like, oh my god.
Put an axe to
all of them.
I was like, alright, well, makes
blood
sense.
Came out. That was cool.
There's the two Gravity Falls references. One was when there's a character from Gravity Falls briefly in the background of a shot. Mm. And then Alex Hirsch, the creative Gravity Falls, was the jock.
The handsome guy. Interesting. Gotcha. Yeah, I've heard good things about that show as well.
Yeah, they're slightly intertwined, just very, very minimally. I think the creators of this and that, so Justin Roiland and Alex Hirsch, should like share an office at Disney or some shit.
That's cool.
Mm-hmm. Interesting.
So if you could put that thing on your head, would you do it to see, what do you think of Mickey and what do you think of Novi?
Oh yeah, 100%. You gotta do it.
Yeah.
I don't know.
We should. That could be a funny skit.
I don't know. Okay.
I refuse to participate in this funny skit.
Marquetta!
Don't listen to him.
We should
I'll
do that.
The hat. The hat looked cool.
Yeah, we should do that. Okay, that could be a funny ass skit.
That would look pretty funny.
Jerry.
Just puts his ass in the air and he gets in trouble.
It's like,
no one's doing this.
That's hysterical, man.
Okay. It's fucking gross.
But that's a good idea, though,
conceptually, though.
But in the end, they kind of actually, even the alternative images, they needed each other because she was like, I'm the only one, and she needed all the Jerrys to take over the world.
Yeah,
like,
but they're codependent is the problem, is that they both have problems, and instead of fixing those problems, they're fucking hindering each other to come try and keep the fucking cycle going. So this is it. Like, this is what they do.
Yeah.
They pretty much are an off-again-on-again marriage.
But remember when they did that episode where they were alternative universe, even if they that was
the
like
Cronenberg universe?
Yeah, when they like they end up get coming together.
Oh, you know what? They do the same thing in the interdimensional commercial one.
Like
Jerry's well, Jerry's why you can put on the glasses and watch yourself from a different dimension, and Jerry's a fucking
about.
Rock star.
Oh, yeah, and then but he ends up coming like, back.
Yeah.
Back
or movie
her.
Star.
And she's the one who like got abortion, but like she
yeah.
became a famous
yeah.
doctor.
Yep.
Yeah.
But she was still a fucking drunk. Dirty wine now. Like in the last episode, she hits her daughter in the eye.
Some people are just meant for each other, no matter how bad they are for each other.
So if you put that helmet on, what would you see for Chris? What's Chris's manifestation?
A little rhino.
You look very nice, by the way. I like your necklace.
Yeah,
thank you. Wait, so they were showing the lowest, like.
They just like what they subconsciously think of each other.
The couples therapy thing.
Oh.
Remember, it's the one with Tiny Rick.
Let's do animals. So what animal would Chris be?
Animal.
Yeah, what animal am I, babe?
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah, let's do animals.
Before we sign off.
Or elephant.
Elephant?
No. Elephant's good. Elephant
should we say what can animal I be a bear? We think... Should I say like what animal like I think she is or what animal she thinks I am?
No, what He's animal you think you I am. Don't make this as complicated as
I can be a bear. Nobody asked you, Tiffany.
You're Ella dog.
I'm an Ella dog, so I'm an elephant and a dog.
You're from the Avatar universe and you're...
Or like...
She's like an owl.
Aww.
She's got the glasses and she's just like, ooh, ooh, I know a lot of things.
Oh, I know exactly what you are.
I'm an owl. I'm not cat to the owl.
I don't want to know. I don't want to know.
Nubby is a honey badger. because she's small and cute, but she will not be afraid to fight a cobra. Like she
honey badgers fight cobras?
Yeah.
Honey badger don't give a fuck.
Fought a cobra, passed out from the venom, woke back up and ate him again.
Haven't you seen
that? Haven't seen that?
Honey badger don't give a fuck.
Oh, we have to watch that before we leave.
Oh yeah, Nubby's a honey badger, dude.
I think Mickey's a puppy. He gets distracted so quickly and then like, what? And then he just like runs away.
Which
what breed? What kind of puppy?
Which breed?
Your lab puppy.
Oh right, my
I'll
god!
Take it. I'm Doug.
It's
Doug
like yeah, it's like you call
he's
and they're like, all right, and then he's something. It's like gone.
I'll take
gone, and he goes to a room and you never see him.
I'll take Doug from up. Yeah, I can see that.
Actually, yeah.
I'll tell you what syringe is. I would say like an otter. Like kind of like a little fuckboy animal that kind of fucks with you, but it's also like super sincere though.
He is an otter.
Otters are sincere. Otters rape seal babies to death.
Whoa.
Yeah.
All right.
Whoa.
What do you what do you think Margie is, and what do you think Margie thinks of you?
Yes.
All right. What do you think Margie is?
She's never gonna see this anyway.
Rule Baker sees.
It's a hard one. You guys are
trying to.
Don't just roll with chinchilla.
But she is a little chinchilla.
Chinchilla.
She washes herself in volcanic ash.
Yeah.
Well, yes, because one time.
Let's say right.
Bye. Bye, y'all. Pam, you saying bye? Pam says bye. Hey guys, thanks for watching the episode of Rick and Morty with us. Big Trouble in Little Sanchez. Shoutouts to Luis, Joe Maggs, Lauren S., and Abel. Don't forget, you can watch these a week in advance through our early access on Patreon. Like and subscribe. All of that really helps. Thanks a ton, guys. Peace.